Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the next topic. The lesson is body movement. You know, the before itself, we should know about that living and non-living things. So, the living things, you know, like the plants and animals, we are always saying that living things. You know, how do you say that living organism has some special character? What are the special character? Growth, movement, respiration, reproduction, and feelings. So that's why plants and animals is considered upon the living things. Isn't it? And non-living things mean, so these are the character, you know, does not have any character. Does not have any character. The living organism does not growth. It's not movement, it's no respiration, no reproduction, everything is absent. So that's why we are saying that non-living things. Okay? So non-living things mean nothing but the non-living things does not have any character. Does not have any character. Okay. And so this is everything is introduction about this topic. And cell, you know, all the living organism is made up of cell. All living organism made up of cell. Without cell there is no organism. You know, all the living organism is made up of cell. It's very important. The cell, first cell, compared to me. Tissue, then organ, organ after organ system. So cell, the cell is, okay, all living organism is made up of cell. Okay, what? Cell to compare to make a tissue. Tissue to compare to make a organ. Organ to compare to make a organ system. So there is a common for all living organism. Both plants as well as animal itself. Okay. Next. So the cell, you know, the sum organism is made up of that, you know, the single cell and multicell. Single cell and multicellular organism. Multicell. The single cell, that means the organism made up of single cell. The organism is made up of single cell. That is called the single cell organism or the unicellular organism. That means what? The organism made up of single cell. Okay, what? That is called the single cell or unicellular organism. Single cell or unicellular organism. Okay. And the organism made up of more than two cells. That is called multicellular organism. That is called what? Multicellular organism. All living organism made up of cell. You know, the such kinds of organism is made up of one cell or single cell. That is called the unicellular organism. Okay, what? Multicellular organism means the sum organism is made up of more than two cells. That is called what? Multicellular organism. Okay, so that is one of the example, one of the introduction of this topic. And next, now we are going to talk about the topics, that body movement. You know, body means compound with many parts. That is called body. Okay, what? The body means nothing but to combine that many parts, that is called what? Body. This body consists of like head up to the bottom, you know, head and eyes and nose and ear and lip and hand and chest and stomach and abdomen, you know, and legs. Everything we are saying about body. The body means nothing but the whole parts, that is called body. And the body movements, like sometimes body parts it can move and sometimes whole body can move from place to place. So the body movement, basically they are two types, you know, the body movement. Okay, the body movement basically they are classified in the two types. First one, the organism move the body. Okay, ma? The organism move the body parts in one or two or more direction. Okay, ma? The organism move the body parts. Organism move the body parts. Body parts. More direction. But do not change their position. But do not change their position. So it's one kind of movement. Okay, what? First one was the organism move the body parts. Here only it can move the body part. For example, my hands always rotate front and back. If I hear itself, in my hand only will be rotate. Again, they will come at the same place. Give up. So the dog also move the body parts in one or two more direction. Give up. But do not change their position. Have you got it? So this is my hand normal position. Okay, ma? When you rotate my hand, like front side or back side and side. Okay, ma? And again. Okay, ma? Next one will happen. Back. Do not change your position. There is no change the position. Okay, ma? It's one kind of movement. And second kind of movement, the organism move from place to place is called locomotion. It's called locomotion. Okay, what? So the locomotion means now the whole my body parts, you know, the whole body parts, that is my organism, you know, whole body parts move from one place to another place. Now I am standing in front of you here itself. Now I can move. So now what will happen? My whole parts of the body can move from one place to another place. Now itself, you change the direction. Now I am standing this leg. Now I am standing this way. Okay, so the locomotion means the organism move from one place to another place is called that locomotion. Okay, what? The locomotion means nothing but that organism move from one place to another place is called what? Locomotion. Okay, what? For example, when you are writing on the notebook, which part of body organ you can use? Like hand one. You know, and when you are turning, look in your front, which parts of body parts it can use? You know what? The head and neck regions only will be rotate. But this body parts do not change their position. Once I am looking my front, again my head will come in normal position only. Isn't it? so it's one kind of movement. Okay, well, and when I walk and jump, okay, well, and skipping, okay, well, and jumping and walk. So different body parts we have used their different function. For my hand, using for writing and eating and some purpose only. And my legs is using for walking and some other purpose only. You know, so the different organs have the different body function. Different organs have different body function. Okay, well. So table 8.1, how do animals move from place to place? You know, the different kinds of organs, it can move from one place to another place using the different body parts. Using the different body parts. Like notable, like the cow and humans and snake and birds or insect or fish or etc. human in our book. Okay, so different organism, it can move from one place to another place using the different body parts. Have you understood? And human beings. Okay, well, now I move from one place to another place. Which body part you can use it for movement? My leg. Have you got it? And in some of the animals also. Okay, well, like the insect, you know, insect it can move from place to place using the wings. Birds also it can move from one place to another place using the feathers. So different kinds of organism it can move from one place to another place using the different parts. Okay, well, using the different body parts. Different body parts. Different body parts. So that way the organism moves from one place to another place. While walk, run and jump and breathe and crawl and slither and swim. So different kinds of organism can move from place to place using the different body parts. Have you got it? Next one, the human body and its movement. Okay, the next one, the human body and its movement. Okay, in our body parts, you know, for when we are playing the playground, like when we are doing the physical exercise, so all the time, your whole parts of the body will function. For example, your eye is always blinking, isn't it? And when you are jump, you can use that leg. So, different parts of the body organ, you can use it for different purpose. You know, we enjoy doing the physical exercise at school. How we move our hands and legs while doing the different exercise. When you are playing, we have do some different exercise on the time. We can use the different body parts. Okay, well, like your hand and legs, in your whole body parts, it can move from one place to another place. Okay, well, so when your arms will be rotate. You know, when you are rotating your hand, you know, when you are rotating your shoulder, so that way the arm will be completely rotate. You know, when you are jumping on the ground, definitely your leg automatically started the jumping. And when you are escape and touch your toe, here which kind of organ you can use? Your the hip bone. Okay, well, so the different parts of the body, okay, different parts of the body can using the different function. The different parts of the body perform that different function or different activities. Okay, well, so try to move the various parts of your body and record the movement of table 8.2. Okay, well, why that is, we are able to move few parts of body easily in various different direction or someone in one direction. So I told you, know when you are a friend calling, you can turn and again you come and sit in the same position. The position do not change. Okay, well, do not change your position. Okay, well. So the next one, the organ, you know, the organ can transfer in the two types. What is that? Internal organ and is to an external organ. So the internal organ. One is the internal organ. Second one is the external organ. The internal organ, you know, the some parts of body it can found in the inside our body. Inside our body. That is called the internal organ. Okay, wow. Some human parts it found in inside our body. That is called what? The internal organ. Internal organ. Okay, wow. For example, like heart, liver, kidney, etc. etc. And some body parts it can found in the outside our body, that is called the external. The internal means nothing but the inside, and external means outside. In some parts of the body, it found in outside our body, that is called the external organ. For example, eyes, nose, ear, etc. So that is here. External organ. So there are the two types of organs there. One is the internal organ, next one external organ. The internal means nothing but the organ is found in inside our body, that is called internal organ. And external organ means organs is found in outside in our body, that is called the external organ. Okay, what? That is called what? External organ. Example, eye, nose, and ear. Okay. Okay, great, students.